Gildan Media presents Your Coach in a Box, affordable life-changing audio programs.
Treasure Mapping with Feng Shui and NLP. Jen Magner and Christiane Turner. As this program contains parts that might induce a light trance, please make sure that you are in a comfortable and safe place without any distractions or activities while you are enjoying the information. Dedication. This program is dedicated to all of you people out there who make a difference in the world. No matter if it's by helping your neighbor, being part of a volunteer team, having a conversation with your checkout clerk at the grocery store, or making the phone call to the relative who is in the hospital or nursing home. There are so many ways we can positively contribute to the world around us. And it all starts with how we conduct ourselves in our own lives and what we are able to create for ourselves. Introduction. Before we start our journey, let me share with you a poem by the mystic poet Jim Hawkes. Find what is hidden. Deep inside you is a treasure. It lies deep in the cave of the soul, your heart. Your heart's passion wants to be found, your true potential, your dream. Find what is hidden. Ah, let those words sink in, finding the treasure hidden deep within, in the cave of the soul. Yes, that's right. This is exactly the journey we are inviting you to join us. Allow Jen and me to be your tour guides on this exploration as we venture into unknown territory, the deep recesses of your soul, to uncover the treasure hidden within you. And not only will we create a map together to get to your treasure, we also offer you the tools to enjoy your treasure to your heart's desire in your everyday life, once you have found it. Over a decade ago, my dear friend and collaborator Jen introduced me to treasure mapping with Feng Shui, which she had fused into a very creative model. Over time, we added NLP-based exercises to the process and are now looking at a workable model that has proven itself again and again. We will share some of the stories that have been told to us, as well as our own experiences with you, so you can easily map the methods over into your own life. Being proactive in our goal setting is a very important part in creating our reality. And the treasure mapping model is offering a fun and exciting way of raising our consciousness and taking our whole existence to the next level by transforming specific aspects of our life. Truly, this is a time of great transformation. Raising consciousness is not a solitary journey anymore of a few avatars or sages. It is a journey for humanity at large and connects all of us. This is a worldwide social epidemic as more people every day join the movement until an actual paradigm shift is achieved and humanity evolves to the next level of consciousness. Each one of us plays an important role in this evolution as we individually incorporate new beliefs, behaviors, and skills into our own lives. We consistently learn and evolve. And as we transform, the people around us naturally move to the next level of consciousness also. The evolution is systemic and seems magical in how easy it is. Years ago, I used to believe that magic was connected with occurrences out of the ordinary. Now I understand that what appears as magic actually has an underlying structure, and that there is a technology that supports these so-called phenomena. This is exactly the territory our treasure map will guide us through as we take the journey together through this program. There are many factors that can help expedite the integration of new behaviors, skills, and beliefs, and compel us to become more proactive co-creators of our lives. Treasure mapping with Feng Shui and NLP touches on many such factors as it weaves a path through all areas of life. We learn to let go of the past and what does not serve us anymore, while we are being able to be present in the moment as we proactively create our future. In order to fully grasp the scope of what we are talking about, we need to first understand the individual models that this program is based on. Let us start in the beginning with the ancient teachings of Feng Shui and the I Ching.
First there was the one, then there was two, then 10,000 things. These words are an interpretation from the ancient oracle known as the I Ching, which means the Book of Changes. This wisdom is said to have been written over 3,000 years ago. It is a study of how humans can use nature as a map to navigate their lives. Even before there was written language, humans had to learn how to live in nature in order to survive. They learned which side of the mountain was a better place to dwell, to be protected from the winds and rain. They learned when and where to grow food, what plants were medicinal, where to get pure water. By living in oneness with nature, they learned deeper messages from the elements, how to flow with what is, and also when things get out of balance, how to get back into balance. Today we live in a time where we have gotten out of touch with nature. Now we are aware of our impact on nature and are waking up to ways we can come back into balance with the elements. Just as our ancestors learned what worked and what didn't work, we are also returning to being in harmony with all that is. Feng Shui is a study some say was based on the I Ching. I, however, feel it's older than the written version of the I Ching. It is, for me, a practical way of using the wisdom that is expressed in the I Ching. For the purposes of this audio tape, just allow the wisdom of these two systems to blend together and go deep within you. Tap into that ancient aspect of yourself, that inner knowing, way down into your DNA, to search for the treasures within. We will be using the I Ching, Feng Shui, NLP, and treasure mapping as tools for you to find the hidden diamonds and jewels that are in the depths of your soul. Christiane and I will act as guides to help you safely explore untapped resources that will help you find the valuables you have hidden from yourself. We will give you equipment on this adventure so you can climb over any mountains that have been on your path. Scuba dive to the depths of your core, navigate through rough waters, and burn off any old limited programming that is now no longer useful. We are grateful that you have chosen to go on this journey and honored that you have had the courage to explore your deeper self. Most of all, we are excited to be your guides on this, the greatest adventure of your life, finding the treasures within. So where do we start? Let's start with the beginning quote. First there was the one. What does that mean? We are dealing with being one with all that is here. Quantum physics is now teaching us that we are all a part of this unlimited cosmic soup. There is a seen and unseen world that goes beyond what linear thinking can conceive. So that is where you have to go, beyond thought, into your core, and tap into that deeper knowing that exists within. That means, on the quantum level, when you break down your DNA to the tiniest level of seen matter, there is more space than physical matter. Therefore, you are more space than physical material. That space in between is part of all that is it not? The physical is your personal projection of all that is, which means you are a part of the whole universe. Tap into that feeling for a moment. What does that feel like to be a part of the universal consciousness? What does that look like in your mind's eye? Does it have a sound? Take all the time you need to explore this. You can turn off the audio program anytime you need more time to process this material. Once you have tapped into that universal consciousness, you will never be the same. You will realize how vast you really are, knowing on a deep level that you have all the resources within. Take a few breaths as you realize this. Breathe in and out, in and out, in and out. It is very important that you breathe as you process this material, as it helps your brain integrate the material. It is also wise to have water nearby to hydrate your brain as you create new neural pathways. As you now have become one with all that is, imagine what it would be like to separate into the two. Go ahead. Feel that dividing feeling just for fun. Make one side be dark and the other light. Make the dark side moist, wet, receptive, passive, cold, soft, female. Take all the time you need to get that in your visual context. Notice any sounds that may show up. How does that feel in your body? Now shake that off with your whole body. Do a little wiggle dance. And be sure to breathe. Now, check out your other half. What does it feel like to be light, active, male, creative, hot, hard, dry? Notice what is different. Does that look different to you? Was there any sound? How did that feel in your body? These are all ways you can get more in touch with what is going on in your body and mind. You have just experienced the yin-yang principle. I am sure you have seen that oriental symbol that is a circle with a black and white teardrop shape inside. The black shape represents the female or yin principle, and the white teardrop shape represents the male principle or yang energy. Just breathe for a moment, in and out, in and out, in and out. Which is more important, breathing in or breathing out? Exactly. They are both essential. This is what you want in your life, a balance between the receptive energy and the active energy. That is why there is a white dot in the black swirl and a black dot in the white swirl. For example, if all you do is work 90 hours a week, what happens? Eventually you crash, sometimes even get sick, so the body can rest. You need to be in balance with these two energies in your life. Just as the wave comes in and goes out, one is not better than the other. Another example of this is, perhaps you are a giver. You give and give and give. What happens? Yes, you crash. You need to open up to receive as well as give. I always tell my clients that it is just as hard for a giver to receive as a taker to give. Again, we want balance. Practice breathing again and notice if exhaling is longer than inhaling. If exhaling is longer than inhaling, practice getting them the same. Remember to breathe from your belly and keep your shoulders down. It is good to inhale through your nose and out your mouth with your jaw slackened, making more of a ah sound. Practice that for a moment. Just say, ah. Make sure it is a low, relaxed sound. Relax your throat. Practice this a few more times by turning off the audio program until you feel relaxed. Notice how you feel now. Are your shoulders down? Is your voice lower? Is your vision softer? Just notice what you notice. You may want to jot a few notes down about this. You have practiced being one, then two. What does it mean to be 10,000 things? Just as you start with one cell, which divides into two, look at all the cells that make up your body. You can't begin to count them, can you? In Oriental medicine, they start with the I Ching and then divide it into five elements. Earth, wood, fire, water, and metal. There are different organs that are associated with each element. Again, the goal is to keep all these elements in balance. This also goes for your environment. As above, so below. As within, so without. You want to be in balance both with your body, mind, spirit, as well as balanced with your surroundings. We will go more into how to do that later in the program. As we continue to build on the I Ching principle of staying in balance with the elements, know that each element feeds into the next. A good way to remember that is to think of it this way. Earth creates metal. Metal holds water. Water feeds wood, wood fuels fire, and fire makes earth. Just allow your mind to relax around that information, as it will make sense later on. Right now, you just need a taste of that to build your map. Speaking of maps, we are now going to explore the Bagua map. This will be the basis for your treasure map that you can start assembling now. Get a piece of paper and make a large tic-tac-toe grid on the whole paper. If you don't remember how to do that, it is two vertical lines separating the paper into thirds, and then two horizontal lines separating the paper into three horizontal columns. Do you now have 9 boxes? Yay! You have just made a Bagua map. Yahoo! Now we're talking. Now you will be filling in the quadrants with information. That will be useful to transfer onto your larger treasure map that we will be making throughout the rest of the program. This is your practice sheet. First, let's start by putting the elements associated with certain quadrants or guas on this paper. That will give you your foundation. Start by putting the word earth in the center gua. Make it small as you will be adding more information to each area. To the left of the center gua, in the middle of the left-hand column, write wood. Again, you want this to be small. To the right of the center gua, in the right-hand column, write the word metal. Above the center gua, in the center column, write fire. Below the center gua, in the center column, write water. Your map should have the 5 words in the guas making a perfect balanced cross shape. Now, each of these 9 guas represent 9 areas of your life and have colors, shapes, and meaning. Remember when we were talking about the yin-yang principle? The yin is represented with a horizontal line with a space in between, like a dotted line. The yang principle is shown up as a solid line. The yin is the female, more receptive aspect. The yang is the male, more active, solid aspect. Each of these nine quadrants have what is called a trigram, which means three lines. The combination of the three lines lets us know what kind of elemental energy makes up that area. Now is a good time to take notes, make symbols, and gather pictures that will represent those qualities for you. We will start with the center gua. Have you ever seen a Chinese coin? It usually has a square hole in it. The square shape represents the element of earth. In the center gua, there are no trigrams. Instead, the yin-yang shape is usually put here. The color for this is yellow and earthy tones. The meaning of this area is presence. This is the most important area, as this is where you want to create the feeling of being centered, grounded, and aligned with your highest truth. You are the center of your world. Allow the energy of the universe to flow through you, just like the Chinese coin. This has no particular body part that it is associated with. It encompasses every part of the body, not designated to any of the other areas. We will go into more detail into each of these guas with exercises later on in this audio program. Right now we are giving you an overview of the bagua map, so you can get started getting ideas for making your treasure map that you will be building. Now move down into the left bottom corner of your bagua map. This area is called your knowledge and self-cultivation gua. The underlying principle for this gua is wisdom. The color for this area is blue. The Chinese name for this area is Gin, which means mountain. The I Ching trigram that represents this area is a solid yang line, with two broken yin lines stacked underneath. The body part that this is associated with is the hand. Move directly above this gua, and you are in the health and family gua, where you wrote the word wood. The shape for wood is the column. The color that represents this area is green. The underlying meaning is strength. The Chinese name is Jin, which means thunder. The trigram looks like two yin lines on top of one yang line. The body part that this is related to is the foot. Move up on the bagua map to the top left corner. You will find the wealth area. The underlying meaning is gratitude. The I Ching word for this is sun, which means persistent influence of wind. The trigram has two yang lines stacked on one yin line. The color purple represents this area, and the body part that is associated with this area is the hip. Continuing now around the bagua map clockwise, you will come to the middle column above the center gua. This is the fame area. The color is red, and the meaning is integrity. The I Ching name for this area is Li, which means clinging fire. Remember, this is where you put the word fire. The shape associated with fire is the triangle. Trigram shape for this area is the yang solid line on top of a broken yin line, which is on top of another yang line. The body part that goes with this area is the eye. Keep moving to your right, to the right top corner. There you will find the relationship corner. The color for this area is pink. The Chinese word for this is Qin, which means receptive earth. This area is the most yin of all the areas, as it has three yin lines stacked on top of each other. Are you starting to make the correlations now? Hang in there. We only have three left after this one. All the major organs of the body are associated with this gua. Now go directly under the relationship area to the children and creativity gua, which is located to the direct right of the center gua. This is where you place the element of metal. The shape for metal is the circle, and the color is white. The Chinese name for this gua is Dui, which means joyous lake. The trigram looks like a yin line above two yang lines, and the body part is the mouth. Drop down one quadrant below the creativity gua, and you come to the travel and helpful people area. The Chinese name for this is Qian, which means heaven. The color is gray. The trigram here is the most yang of all the guas, three yang solid lines stacked on top of each other. The body part is the head. Lastly, we come just left of the travel and helpful people area to the career gua. The color is black and the shape is wavy, as this is associated with the element of water. The Chinese word for this area is kun, which means deep water. The trigram is a yin line on top of a yang line with another yin line beneath. The body part is the ear. Whew! You made it all the way around the Bagua map. That is a lot of information. I hope you took notes. We have given you an overview of the I Ching and broken that down into the Bagua map. Now, how do you put this all together with NLP and treasure mapping?
First of all, generally speaking, a map is a visual two-dimensional representation of a specific geographic area, like a city. Now, a treasure map is a very special map that immediately takes us beyond the ordinary way of looking at maps as navigational tools to a place of wonder, curiosity, and excitement. The lure of the treasure map is plainly stated in its name. We are talking about treasures here, riches and valuables. Usually hidden from plain sight, often forgotten that they even exist, until the map shows up and gives us the perfect clues that help us find the hidden treasure. In NLP, we like to say that the map is not the territory, which means that our perception of reality and reality itself are two different things. The basic intent of a map is to be useful in giving directions. The more accurate the map is, the better we are off as we navigate through life. We get in trouble if we follow the wrong path, or if our map is ineffective, because it is not a very good representation of the territory. It might be missing major mile markers.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.